We had just left Monrovia, and we're piled in the back of Rich's work pickup truck. And we are pressed knee to knee, thigh to thigh, sweat on skin. Bob Marley booms from the speaker, then the lesser lauded Lucky Doobie, who pauses for his trio of background, singing ladies to chant to us. Do you want to be a well-fed slave or a hungry free man? Do you want to be a well-fed slave or a hungry free man? We are in Liberia, and it is 5 days before Trump's immigration travel ban is announced. And I don't yet have an answer to Lucky's question, but my head bobs along to his roots rock reggae as we drive by towns with names so sweet like candy or honest grown folks love that it stumps me. Bolotota, Bekom, Same, Sakoko, Batala, Zienzu, Mamu, Salala. My niece and the others laugh as I mouth each word, practicing Pele. They tell me that some names mean by the river or water, or by the road or lake, or simply town. But I only hear music as each one passes quickly in the rearview mirror, flies off away from the one lone paved highway we're on, away from Lucky's urgent croning. Do you want to be a well-fed slave or a hungry free man? Do you want to be a well-fed slave or a hungry free man? And none of us have the answer as we watch each town repeat itself with the same barefoot children and coal pots and empty pockets and mud shacks and laughing elders and gorgeous, gorgeous black faces frozen in smiles, repeating and disappearing into dirt roads and dust as our heads bob to Bolotota, Bekom, Same, Sakoko, Batala, Zienzu, Mamu, sweet, sweet, Salala.